Universal Audio's EP34 Tape Echo Powered Plugin is an incredibly faithful representation of the vintage Echoplex EP3 and EP4 tape delay units. The Echoplex effect, heard on countless classics ranging from Led Zeppelin and David Bowie to Radiohead to Joe Satriani, provides warm, rich delays and a tone unlike anything else. UA combined the best of the original EP3 and EP4 units into a single plugin and added some digital-only features that make the plugin even more fun to use. In this video, I'll talk about the unique properties of the Echoplex tape delay and go through the controls of the EP34 plugin and demonstrate them with various audio sources. The original Echoplex hardware uses an infinite tape loop combined with a sliding record head, and that's how the delay time is adjusted. But the real fun is had by moving the tape head around while audio is playing and cranking up the echo repeats until the unit goes into self-oscillation. The EP34 powered plugin captures every nuance of this unique sound, as well as the many other unique properties of the original hardware. Here's an example of the EP34 on some vocal tracks. I've automated a few of the controls and went for an over-the-top effect so you can really hear the EP34 at work. I can also put the EP34 into self-oscillation and adjust the delay time, just like the hardware. Let's hear it on this guitar track. Now I'll go through the EP34 controls so you can see how I got these effects. Probably the main controls you'll use are the delay time and echo repeats. These are the heart and soul of the EP34. The delay slider controls the delay time, and you can see the delay time displayed here. You can hear the audio warping as I move the slider around. You can use the scroll wheel on your mouse to do this as well. If I move it fast enough, you'll hear a high-frequency squeal, just like the hardware. The Echo Repeats control can turn the EP34 from a subtle, warm delay unit into a raging, howling beast with one quick turn. When set low, the delays are under control and decay nicely. You can even hear the wow and flutter of the tape. But when set just above 4, the EP34 is on the verge of self-oscillation. This is the sound that made Tape Echo famous. Turned up past this point, the delay begins to saturate the tape and the repeats are distorted. Move the delay slider around and you can create some amazing sounds. The echo volume controls the mix between the dry signal and the audio played back from the tape, very much like a mix control. The record volume control increases the gain on the input stage right before the record head. Turning this up sends a hotter level to the tape, causing the signal to saturate. Turned up high, the input stage itself begins to distort, adding a fuzz pedal-like distortion to the signal. As you can see, the LEDs tell you when you're getting into the red, if you can't hear it already. Like the hardware, the EP34 has treble and bass controls, and these affect the delayed signal coming off the tape. The filtering effect provided is akin to guitar amp tone stacks. In the middle position, they provide a flat effect, but turned left or right, they boost or cut the high or low frequencies. You can make shimmering delay effects by turning the treble up and the bass down. or warm fat echoes by turning down the treble and turning up the bass. As I mentioned earlier, there are some digital-only features that we added to the EP34, and I used a few of them, along with automation, to create the effects on the vocal tracks. Echo Pan lets you pan the tape-delayed signal left or right. You'll need to have it on a stereo track, though. The input switch models the two physical inputs on the hardware. Low input has lower output and basically creates cleaner echoes, and doesn't distort as easily, while the high input is more easily saturated. On the Echoplex hardware, there's a tension setting underneath the delay slider. The tension switch on the plugin emulates two settings of delay slider tension. When set to low, the slider moves quickly and the delay response is faster. The high setting emulates tight tension, resulting in slower, more slowly pitch shifted effects. The send switch is similar to what can be found in the RE201 Space Echo plugin. What this does is send audio to the plugin only when it's in the on position. Turning on Tempo Sync switches the EP34 from straight delay time into subdivided delays based on the tempo of your session, something totally impossible with the hardware. You can see the note value in the echo delay readout. The Wet switch lets you use the EP34 in 100% wet mode. Last but not least, the Power switch. Even when the echo volume is all the way down, the dry signal is still subtly affected by running through the EP34. So the power switch completely removes the audible effects of the EP34 out of the signal path. In this song, I had a lot of fun with the EP34. At the end of the song, I put the EP34s into self-oscillation, then used the delay times to tune them to make a sound collage, so to speak. Now this is going to be a bit over the top, but this way you can really hear the effect. And this is best listened to on headphones.